My brothers and sisters, we all know that helping people is a duty of ours as believers. We believe in Allah. He is the maker who made me. He made you. He made entire creation. This creation was not created without a purpose. Part of the deal is that those who are able and capable to assist those who are incapable and unable should do so. So if you are able to assist someone else, the connection between you and the rest of the creatures of Allah from the greatest distance would be the bare minimum, your creator is one. This includes animals and plants and this environment, the globe, the other planets, Mars and whatever else you want to say, the moon, everything created by whom? Allah. Allah asks you to ponder over the creation of the skies and the earth. And He says that that pondering itself, those who think about how the day and the night rotate and spend time to do that, are actually the intelligent. They are the ones who are those with sound minds, ulul albab. Why would that be? Because it leads you to understand and realize the greatness of the Creator and how small and minute we are. We've spoken about this in the past, the vastness of what lies beyond this particular earth. But today, I'd like to highlight the benefit of reaching out to others. Why? What is it in there for me? And the reason why I have to say this is, man is such that if there's no benefit for him somewhere, he becomes reluctant. He becomes reluctant. You have a deal. Someone says, can you give me $200? It is very difficult for people of today to come up and say, yes, I will give you. Number one. And you give it away. Or a good person will still say, I give you 200. Give me back the 200 in a year. Still a good man. But it is so tempting to ask, what is in it for me? Subhanallah, because that is human. وَأُحْضِرَتِ الْأَنفُسُ الشُّحُ. You see the nafs, the soul, the people, the inside. Allah speaks about how selfish, high level of selfishness. Shuh. Each one wants goodness for himself. When you can break that barrier, you've connected with Allah. When you can break that barrier of selfishness to a level of selflessness, you have connected with Allah in a much greater way. So we ask Allah to grant us the ability to care, not just for ourselves, but for all others. That's why if you take a careful look at man's needs, they are very basic. Beyond that need, something not necessary, you don't need it, Allah will give you. Not for you, you will die without using it. A man who's a billionaire is never going to use those billions. Never ever in his life. No matter what he does, it's either going to be wasted or something will happen. But even if he eats throughout the 24 hours of a day, he will not manage to complete all that or to finish the money. If he does and buys whatever luxuries, he won't get an opportunity to use all of that. Because Allah says, you know what, man, you are so minute, you are so small, your needs are so limited, we have guaranteed you that we will provide. It is upon us to provide for you the basics.